how to integrate Altivar SIP Safety Module VW3A3809 with EcoStruxure Control Expert. Hello! Today we will show you how to set up SIP safety communication between an Altivar variable speed drive and an M580 safety PLC using a SIP safety module VW3A3809 through EcoStruxure Control Expert. There can be two architectures for the Altivar SIP safety solution. The first architecture is ATV930 plus SIP safety module VW3A3809 plus additional module support VW3A800 plus M580 safety PLC. The second architecture is ATV340 plus SIP safety module VW3A3809 plus M580 safety PLC. In this video, we will demonstrate the first architecture using an M580 safety PLC, BMEP584040S. Here's how the STO, Safe Torque Off, works. When the STO is activated, the safety function disables the torque-generating power fed to the motor. Then, the motor stops in freewheel mode. Please refer to the ATV900 installation manual or the ATV340 installation manual and the ATV SIP safety user manual. Before inserting the SIP safety module, your drive must have been basically configured according to application, motor control parameters, configuration of communication parameters, and encoder parameters. Check if needed, then apply auto-tuning. Please refer to Altivar Getting Started for more details. Insert SIP safety module for Altivar as per the SIP safety instruction sheet. First, we will show you the insertion with ATV900, then with ATV340. For ATV900, remove the graphic display terminal and the inferior part of the additional module support. Unscrew the four captive screws and remove the cover. Insert the SIP safety module. Connect RJ45 cable coming from M580 Safety PLC to Altivar Drive. Refit the cover by screwing the four captive screws. Reconnect the graphic display terminal. Go to Communication menu and configure the IP address of the drive. Restart the drive. Go to Complete Settings menu and select Safety Module. The SIP safety module is not yet configured, and the state is waiting for TUNID. For ATV340, remove the cover and insert the SIP safety module. Then, connect RJ45 cable coming from PLC, connect it to Ethernet port of drive. Link to SIP safety module is done internally. Here is the commissioning procedure for safety drive integration through EcoStruxure Control Expert. Step 1. Configure IP address for M580 Safety PLC. Open EcoStruxure Control Expert. Create a new project with M580 Safety System BMEP584040S with application password. Create a password for your project. refer to the M580 safety manual. Open the PLC bus configuration. Right-click on Open Submodule. Configure M580 PLC IP address. Step 2. Generate safety network number for M580 Safety PLC. In the Safety tab, generate SNN, Safety Network Number. Validate the modification. Step 3. Add Altavar DTM under Ethernet IP field bus. Open the FDT DTM browser. Right-click Master PLC DTM and connect. Then do a field bus discovery using Ethernet IP channel. First, select your SIP safety drive, then select the match DTMs. Click on the plus button and confirm. Select load data from device. Enter the username admin and default password will be web server password. You can find it with the graphic display terminal in My Preferences MYP menu, then Web Server WBS. Step 4. Add Altavar Safety EDS under Safety Field Bus. Right-click Master PLC DTM. Do a Field Bus Discovery. Select the SIP Safety EDS files. Select Safety Input, Producing. You must choose an RPI value between 20 and 1,000 milliseconds. Step 5. Generate safety network number for Altavar SIP safety device. Generate SNN for safety drive. Step 6. Configure safety configuration signature. This step is optional. Step 7. Set TUN ID for Altavar SIP safety device. Compile, build the project, and transfer the project to M580 Safety PLC. Connect online with Safety EDS. Go to Device Diagnosis menu. The SIP Safety module is not configured yet. Module Safety, MS, LED flashes red, then green. Go to the Safety tab. Set TUN ID to Drive. After setting SNN to drive, the safety communication between the PLC and the safety drive can be enabled through the setting of Control_N and Control_OUT_BITS to 1 in the corresponding SIP safety device DDT. After enabling SIP safety communication, check SIP safety communication status is in executing state and module state, MS, LED, is green fixed. In this demo, we are controlling the Altavar drive using SOMOVE control panel. Open Project Browser. Go in the Program Safe tab, Variables and FB Instances, and open Elementary Variables. Select Device DDT and see the safety assemblies. Select the instances of the safety device and click on Initialize Animation Table. Important! For programming application, link safety tags to process tags and refer to Modicon M580 Safety Manual. Deactivate STO function by setting output.safe_torque_off to 1. We can see on the graphic display terminal that the drive is in NST state. Open the control panel. Run Altavar drive using DTM after enabling the control and setting a reference frequency. And verify the status on the graphic display terminal. Activate STO function by reset output.safe_torque_off to 0. See the graphic display terminal HMIS state as STO state. ASF LED is yellow fixed, and the motor stops in freewheel. Thank you for watching. For more information, please visit our website.